Bienvenidos al mundo de Patrice Schmidt. Yo Patrice, or Patricia Schmidt. Born American, I am made with Mexican parts. Mi madre es mexicana, and my father is white American. Entonces, estoy mexicana americana. I have a large family. My brother and I are the youngest of 8 children. The others are born to different fathers. My mother has very strong Mexican values and expects her children to place the family before self-interest. Espera a sus hijos a la familia antes de colocar el interés propio. However, my father appreciates self-reliance and independence. My dad lets me pretty much do whatever because he trusts me. My mom, though, would rather me stay home to help her out around the house. And they do. But, I don't know, maybe it's one of those things, those Spanish traditions where girls stay in. It gets me frustrated because, you know, it's the United States, you know, equality. I get frustrated, you know, me and my mom never get along. Never. She tries to hit me or my little brother. My brother runs, but not me. She wants to hit me, let her hit me, because she's going to get hit back. I don't know. We've always had family problems, because it's a big family. Economic problems, money problems, and stuff. The bills are way too high. My father had to work 2 jobs when I was a freshman, just to make more income. My mom makes my sisters give up half their paychecks to help support the family. I even work a little here and there, which is nice to be out of there. My family may struggle a little bit financially, but they really support me with doing good in school. I remember my parents quizzing me on spelling when I was a younger kid, but they don't really do that for me anymore. They don't really help me in my studies because I'm independent. My mom has a GED and my dad did not go to college. Whenever I need help on my schoolwork, I know I can always count on my half-brother, Martin. He goes here, to the university. My parents always expect me to do well in school, compared to my other brothers and sisters. They'll start yelling at me if I have C's and stuff. But I remember, they didn't do that to the others when they got C's. I get mad because I'm trying and putting all my effort into it. I do have a 3.8 GPA. I do go to school. I was a top fundraiser at Maple High my freshman year. I'm on the swim team. My friends here, on the north side, they call me the rebel, or sometimes call me a nerd, which doesn't bother me or anything, because then they'll say, future vice principal of a corporation, beauty and brains all in one. I don't really have that many friends, or anyone other than my boyfriend that I could get close to. I just don't trust people. I'm a loner for the most part, I'd say. I mean, you know, like, I say hi to people, but it's not the same as having a close friend. One time, a couple years ago, I had 2 good friends that ended up making up all this gossip about me just because I was working after school, trying to make some money. I felt like they stabbed me in the back, so I've learned from it. So, I don't trust people anymore. I get a hard time from my friends sometimes because I don't act like them. I really think of it as if they don't like me for who I am. I ain't gonna change for them, because they used to tell me, oh, look at Miss Executive getting all these high grades. No me importa. I don't really care. At least they know I'm doing something about my life. People don't expect me to be smart. They don't see me as someone, you know, that would get good grades. I tell them, not all blondes are bimbos, you know. My roots are brown. Kids that come from Maple, I guess are sort of in their own world. I guess I believe that, you know, the kids up here have a stereotype of the kids that get busted. You know, they're from the north side. They're gangs, they're violence. I wanted to blow my top one time during class with our student teacher, and they would sort of, you know, put other races down. I just get mad. I just hold it in. No me gusta. I guess you can't really change someone's thoughts unless they want to change their thoughts and stuff. It bothers me, but I can't really do anything about it. I'm a rebel. Personally, I wouldn't want to be something that I'm not. I wouldn't, you know, try to play the role. unless it's in a play or something. I don't have that many friends. I usually hang out with my boyfriend, Roberto. He's not like my last boyfriend. Roberto, he pushes me to do my best. Like, he tells me not to let my studies go, and he pushes me in school. We go running together and stuff. He helps me in Spanish. A lot. So, you know, we push each other to strive for our best. Because he's got high goals. That's what he wants to achieve also. And so do I. I've been involved with PEP, Personal Effort for Progress, since my freshman year. That's what I'm going for, you know, college entrance. I try to take classes that I know that I might use with my future career, like science and math. I want to be a doctor. All PEP students will engage in challenging academic work. You know, they expect you to go to college. Every once in a while, my parents ask me, well, my dad asked me about college, which one I want to go to and how I expect to get there. I tell him, good grades, scholarships, grants if I can, financial aid. Sometimes I think I don't even need PEP, but I guess without it, I really wouldn't know where to go. About college and exams and all that. I know in middle school, I didn't even think about going to college. Maybe a trade school, but when I became a PEP participant, I learned about scholarships and applying to a four-year university. My Northside friends see the schoolgirl attitude with me, getting good grades and all, but my Maple friends see my Northside identity. I value all of the different things equally. It's not one more than the other. I guess that is why I'm a rebel. Soy un rebelde. You rock me in your velvet sea. It's our illusion.